Hello everyone, and I hope you're having a great day and a great holiday. Today I am bringing you my highly anticipated, well, anticipated for me because I'm excited to show you all what I've been hoarding and buying, my holiday slash Black Friday haul. So these are items that I've been buying from Black Friday on to today. I think everything I've bought here either was on sale or I had a coupon that I used, or both. A lot of these items are makeup related, but some are not makeup related. So let's get started because I'm trying to make this video as short as possible. Now the first items that I'm gonna show you are, let's get the non-makeup stuff out the way. Is the Bath and Body Works. I love Bath and Body Works. And actually, if you haven't gone to their website, and guys, I'm sorry, my hair is just, I don't know what's going on with my hair. My hair is like, I stopped taking my Hairfinity and my hair started to break off, and it's just, I need to take my Hairfinity consistently. And if you guys don't know, and it's the first time watching me, I have hypothyroidism, which makes my hair fall out and break off and make it very brittle. So I take vitamins and Hairfinity to help my hair out. So anyway, that out the way before anyone starts, sorry, that's my microwave, before anyone makes a comment. So the items that I bought from Bath and Body Works, the candles, the 3-wick candles at the time were buy one, get one free. Of course, buying one at full price at $22.50 or whatever it costs. The foaming hand soap, which I love their foaming hand soaps. I prefer foaming hand soaps more than the regular hand soaps. That's just my preference. But they were, you know, 6 for $24. And their little scents refill for their plugins were 6 for $24. And I also had a coupon. It was a coupon from Retail Me Not. So anytime you go to any store, guys, I'm telling you, check out Retail Me Not. 8 times out of 10, they have a coupon for the store that you're in. Not all the times, they have online coupons only, but Bath and Body Works is one of those stores that has online and in-store coupons. Now, I did get gifted for a Christmas present, not by the store. The quick disclaimer, none of these items were gifted by any of the companies. None of this stuff is sponsored. All this stuff was either given to me by family for a Christmas present, or I bought them with my own money. So let's get that out of the way. I did get gifted some of the gel hand soaps. So let's get to that part.
So these are the two candles that I bought. Of course, it was buy one at full price, which was $22.50, and get one free. It's Red Velvet Cupcake and Hot Butter Rum. They smelled so, so good. I'm just putting back in this bag and then I'm putting them away. And this is hot buttered rum. And if you see a little person walking in the background, that's my daughter. That's some of her Christmas presents. I bought her the Monster High Castle, and that's been a pain in the rear end to put together. Anyway, so I got for the little Wallflower Home Fragrance Refill, I got Salted Caramel, I got Vanilla Snowflake, another Vanilla Snowflake, Maple Cinnamon Pancakes, Peach Bellini, and this one is Vanilla Bean Noel. Now, my preferred fragrance is vanilla, but you know, sometimes I stray. And these are the deep cleansing hand soaps. These are not foaming. So one of them is Kitchen Lemon, Japanese Cherry Blossom, and this one is Sweet Pea. Now for the handing, for the hands, foaming hand soap, I got Vanilla Snowflake. And right now they are having their year-end sale, so I suggest you check them out, guys. The hand soaps, the foaming and the deep cleansers are $3 for their holiday collection. So, and they also have a sale on their sprays, their body mist and sprays, and their hand lotion. So definitely check them out. And I have Cozy Vanilla, Vanilla Bean Noel, Merry Cookie, Peach Bellini, Very Merry Meringue, Cozy Vanilla Bean, Vanilla Cream, Twisted Peppermint, Cookies for Santa, Vanilla Sorbet, and Boardwalk Vanilla Cone. So this is my next item. This is my mirror, and this mirror is by Flawless Lighting. And if you're interested in this mirror, you can check out flawlesslighting.com, and this is their card. And you can definitely take advantage of that code. Again, this is not a promotional code. This card was in the packaging that I received. So definitely want to use that. Take advantage of it. But this mirror, I truly want the Hollywood Vanity Light mirror, the Hollywood one, but it's super expensive. That is on my wish list. So on Black Friday, this was, I think, 40 or 50% off. So I jumped right on it. I believe it was 50% off, 50 or 40. And I thought it was going to be a little bigger, but I still love it. That's the only flaw or dislike that I have about this mirror, is I wish it was bigger. But it has the power button right here, and it has two settings, bright, and it goes a little dimmer, just like that. Oh great, I just spilled crap everywhere. Oh. Of course. Anyway, I just spilled this, and I have a hanger up here because I was doing laundry, and I spilled this everywhere. Oh my goodness. Anyway, so the mirror has 9 lights. I don't know if these come off at all, but you can, it's portable, so you can put AA batteries in the back, or you can take the AC adapter and plug it into the wall and use it that way. Right now I am using the AC adapter and it's plugged in, but it takes AA batteries. I believe it takes 4 or 3 AA batteries. And that's another setting. So it's like 3 settings that the mirror has. I said 2, pardon me, is 3. So let's move on to our makeup related
items. All right, guys, I'm sorry, I lied. I do have one more item that's non-makeup related. So this I got from Ulta on Black Friday. Oh God, my hair. And this is my favorite brand of shampoo at the moment is Organics. Right now, with my hair being so thin and brittle, not that it helps that I flat iron it all the time and blow it out, but I know that's terrible for my hair, but I'm not gonna stop doing it, because if I don't stop doing it, my hair will look a hot mess, you know, when I go to work. And I try to look presentable and professional as possible within my means to go to work. So anyway, with that being said, I love organic shampoo, but it can be a little pricey. I believe that for one bottle, small bottle like this is like $350 or $450. So on Black Friday, they have buy one, get one free. So I couldn't pass it up. So myself and Miss Benzo, we went to Ulta. And of course, I bought some online. So I got two online, actually. Well, there's two or three I got online. I can't remember. But I'm just going to show you all of them. So I got tea tree mint conditioner, niacin and caffeine conditioner. And these are in no particular order. Eucalyptus mint. Coconut curls. Coconut curl shampoo. The other one is the conditioner. And for any ones that you just see the conditioner for, is because I already own the shampoo and I just needed the conditioner. This is the niacin and caffeine shampoo. Coconut Miracle Oil shampoo. And this one has Damage Remedy Plus. And this is the shampoo. Now, every time I finish a bottle, I change the type that I use, because I feel like if you use the same thing over and over again, your hair becomes accustomed to it. So I try to always, I guess, keep my hair like on top of its game, if that makes any sense. I change it up so that my hair doesn't get accustomed to one type of shampoo. I don't know if that makes any sense. But, you know, it may be all mumbo jumbo and the same one will still work. I like to change it up because I get bored having to use the same thing over and over again. And, of course, I have some samples, some L'Oreal. This is L'Oreal Skin Expert Paris. It has the eye treatment, the Age Perfect Hydra Nutrition Eye, the Age Perfect Facial Oil, and then it has the Golden Balm. And these are free samples. Love free samples. And then this is the Face Finishing Moisturizer. And this is by Pericone MD. I can't even pronounce the other word. Cosmeceuticals. And I bought this NYX Ombre Blush. And this reminds me of the MAC Ombre blushes that they came out a few years ago. It reminded me of that. I love NYX. I love it. It's affordable. And for the most part, the pigmentation is there. So this is what it looks like. And this is nude to me. Nude to me. Very pretty. It doesn't smell like anything. It doesn't have a scent at all. I like to smell things now. I just, you know, if it smells weird, I try not to put it on my face. All right, guys. So the next product I'm going to show you that you already got a glimpse of when I was showing you the Bath & Body Works stuff, the goodies, is my Artist Brush Collection. Now, let me turn this around. So this is the entire original set. They have different sets now. This is the original set. Now, this brush set This brush set cost $350, and that's before taxes. But QVC has them, or HSN, for 5 easy payments. So I took advantage of that, and I bought the set, and this is the white and silver set. Now, I did have, this is oval number 8. This is oval 8. Yes. I have this in the smoky collection, where it's black and like this part is like smoky gray. And that was like, you know, I bought one just to test it out and to see if the buzz on these brushes were legitimate. So I bought the one brush. I bought it, I used it, and I fell in love with it. I was able to use my liquid foundation and then use that same exact brush after I was done applying my liquid foundation. and I was able to apply my powder foundation using the same brush. I fell in love with it, and I did some research, and then I saw they had them on HSN. Is it HSN or QVC? I think it was HSN. I can't remember. But I took advantage of that and bought them. Now they only have, they have them in singles, but not all of the brushes, just some. They have the whole set, but they only have the white and silver ones. They don't have the smoked out or the 24 karat gold ones or the ones that look like little golf clubs. God, my hair looks hot mess. But anyway, but if you were intending of, if you wanted to try them and you were curious about them, I suggest you do your research, watch YouTube videos. I'm a firm believer. All of our skin has a unique chemistry. All of our skin is different. We may have similar chemistry, but it's not the same. The cosmetics that work great for me may not work great for you, but I can only tell you based off of my experience. And that goes for any YouTube guru, any MUA, any influencer. They, just because a product doesn't work for them doesn't necessarily mean that it won't work for me. Now, I do the influencers, the beauty gurus that I watch, the makeup artists that I watch, I do take their advice. But if I do, when I do my own research and I see that it's like, you know, has good reviews or has neutral reviews, I will give it a try. If I don't like it, I'll return it. It's just that simple. Even though returning a product can sometimes be a hassle, you know, I like to see for myself depending on the product. Now, when it comes to lipsticks, I'll tell anyone, give it a try unless it has terrible reviews. I say give it a try because what I like, somebody else may hate, and what I hate, somebody else may like. Like the original, when Milani came out with their liquid lipsticks, like the first batch, I didn't like them. I hated them. And some people raved about them. And my experience was different. You know, they were super drying. I constantly felt like I had to lick my lips, and then they started to chip away. So I haven't tried their new ones, their metallic ones, but I do want to try, you know, I do want to give them a second chance because sometimes the first batch, it's like a trial, open to give them another chance. So anyway, I'm rambling on. Let's get back to the haul. Anyway, the last thing I'm going to say about the artist brushes is if you want to give them a try and you're really curious and, you know, you really want to try them, I suggest buying one. Buy one brush. Test it out, see how you like it. If you don't, you know, if you like it, great. If you don't like them, return them, you know. But I suggest trying the face brushes before trying the eye brushes because I'm still trying to get the gist of how to use the eye brushes. Sorry guys, that's my daughter playing her video game. But I suggest starting with the face brushes and see how you like them from there. So anyway, but they are sold separately on the artist.com website. So you can buy just face brushes if you don't want to try the eye brushes. Or if you do want to get just specific ones, you can. Anyway, the next thing on my list. Holy crap, what can I use next? These little tins from Lime Crime. And I got this one and that one. This one is the Fuchsia Rose. And this one is Red Rose. And the tins, you know, the packaging I think is so cute. And these are the three lipsticks that it brings. One of the lipsticks is Red Rose. The other one is Jingle. And the other one is Sasha. And the Fuchsia Rose little tin has Taffeta, Posh, and Gigi. Very, very cute. They're limited edition and they're $20 each. I wanted to get into a lip care routine. So I saw this one by Bite Beauty. And this is their Whipped Cherry Lip Scrub. And of course, I've been using it already. And it smells like really, really good. Now, this lip scrub, has three out of five stars on Sephora.com's website. So I'm testing it for myself to see how I like it, because I saw the reviews. Oh, my eyeliner's starting to look messy. I'm sorry, guys. I just went over to family's house, and all I have is eyeliner, mascara, falsies, and my eyebrows and some lipstick. And if my lipstick looks faded, it's because I ate dinner. And this came with the lip mask. I think this was $20 or $25. This actually has good reviews, really good reviews. But the lip mask doesn't have good reviews. It has 3 out of 5 stars. And from what I was reading, some people don't feel the little beads scrubbing the lips. For me, it's neutral right now, so I'm kind of testing it out to see how I like it for the next couple days. If I don't like it, I'll return it and try something else. So the next product that I have, I bought these. This is not makeup. Well, it is makeup related, but it's not makeup. It's not a makeup product. I bought these sequins off of eBay. I don't know if you guys have seen any of my old videos, but I have a little tin, like a little plate. Little silver fake plate, and I bought at the dollar store, and I have some makeup things there, and I wanted to do a couple more like that because I used the Pat McGrath packaging, and I wanted to do that again with another little tin. So let me show you guys the next product. I got the Sugar Pill Pumpkin Spice, and it came with this sticker. I have all their stickers since when I think I first purchased an order when they first launched. And as I loved with the way to see a good company grow and how their stickers have evolved. And it came with this little cute packaging. And then it came with this gorgeous, gorgeous liquid lipstick. And this is what it looks like. I would do swatches, but I'm sure if you type it in the search bar, it's been swatched to a million times. This is what it looks like, the eyeshadow, Pumpkin Spice eyeshadow. And it doesn't smell like anything at all. It has no scent. So that's that. First Melt Cosmetics purchase. Oh my God, these are so cute. Now I've taken 3 stacks and put them together. And I have the Dark Matter stack. I have the Dark Matter stack, the Rust stack, and I believe I have one more. I'm trying to figure it out. I just put them all together because it was so cool. I just stuck them all together. I thought that was the neatest thing ever. And the Love Sick stack. But this is how I put them together. All right, guys, so I got 3 stacks, and I have the Dark Matter stack, and I have them like this. And this one is Dark Matter, Enigma. I'm being really careful because I'm infamous for nicking my eyeshadows. Unseen. And this one I nicked. Blur. I nicked it when I was looking at it the first time. Lovesick. That is so pretty. Emily. Fixated. Promiscuous. And that's the little mirror that comes with it. Each one. Take that out. I don't need that there. This is from the Rustac. Rot. Rust. Rubbish. Antique. Yeah, that one got nicked by my computer. Classic. And what I like about these, you can travel with them. Storage is amazing because you can just store it somewhere and forget it. Now, I do recommend if you travel with them to put them somewhere or maybe wrap some kind of tape. So because these come off easy, like they'll get unstuck. Like, they'll, you know what I'm trying to say? Like, they'll move. They'll shift and they'll move, and then you don't want to nick your pretty eyeshadows. But that's my Rust Deck. And I got my first Kat Von D concealer. I have their foundation, and I got Warm 17, or M7, it says M17 Warm. I do want to get her translucent powder, but that'll be on my next purchase. I got 3 MAC Spellbinder eyeshadows. I thought I had 4, but I guess not. I got, this is Retrograde. And I just put this back on here because I don't know why. This one is Blue Karma. And these go right back to the shape. I swatched it. But even if you rub your finger on it, it goes right back to the same pattern. I think that is so freaking cool. And lately, the only thing really I buy from MAC nowadays is just some of their limited edition items that come in their collections. But these eyeshadows, I recommend getting at least one. They are so freaking cool and pigmented. Now, when you swatch them on your fingers, the swatch when you put it on a brush on your eyes, completely different. And this is Mysterious Influence. And that's what it looks like. But definitely, I suggest you get, if you, you know, if you're able to get one, because they are amazing. When I first got into makeup, I used to buy almost MAC everything, and now I buy every brand, it doesn't matter. Now, the next thing I got, this was on sale on Black Friday on Sephora's website, and this is the Shadow Artist Palette number 2, and this is what it looks like. I think it was on sale for $20 or something, or less, $15, I don't remember, but it's so pretty. And the next, oh, and for Christmas, I was gifted a, where is it? A $50 Sephora gift card, which I am so excited about. So excited. I got a free sample of Born This Way Vanilla Foundation because I want to try it. I love my free samples. And, oh, with the last MAC item, I got the MAC Mariah Carey. I got the bronzer, of course. I think that was the first thing that sold out. It's so pretty. I don't want to use it because it's so pretty. But that's what it looks like. I'm sure you've seen this everywhere, but it's so pretty. You see that glitter? I also bought the MAC 239 Mariah Carey brush. I don't know where I put it at, but it's somewhere. But I bought that too. And then I got the ColourPop lipsticks, the days of the week. I have Monday. I have Sunday, and then Monday. I have Tuesday. Wednesday. Thursday. Friday. And Saturday. Now, I didn't get the set because I know they sell them on in sets. I bought some eyeshadows and got some of the days of the week for free. And then when I placed a second order, I got these two ultra matte. I got an ultra matte lip gloss and the color Dropout. And I got an ultra glossy lip in the color Tarot. I got the Hello Kitty collection. I have this. It has the rainbow, the eyeshadow rainbow, friendship file, small gift, and school bus. And move this to the side. I have this part of the collection. Oh, let me get this open. And one lipstick is missing because I was using it. It's a red. It's called Ribbon. This is Kit. Fun with Friends. Yummy Cookies. Bento Box. Sticker Sheet. Juicy Apple. But the Ribbon is a beautiful red color. And then I got the Never Not Chilling. I think it's so cool that this looks like a vinyl disc. And you can feel the ridges. And then when you open it, you have all these beautiful eyeshadows. And here you have Peekaboo, Patchwork, Thirsty Girl, Desert, Babykins, and Fairfax. And that's that. The next ColourPop item that I bought is Loveline. And let's see what eyeshadows we got here. We got Sequin, Truth, Brady, and Static. The next ColourPop item that I bought is the Peachy Queen. And we have Crimper, Kennedy, Cornelius, and Bandit. And this is All Nighter. For this one, you have Smash, Tua T, Mooning, and Vega. Here, I also got the Jeffree Star Holiday Lip Collection. I got all of the colors. We have Deceased, Pumpkin Pie. We have Deceased, Crocodile Tears, Sagittarius, Chrysanthemum, Designer Blood, Checkmate, and Pumpkin Pie. The next thing, I bought this off eBay. I got these lashes right here. They're so cute. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is what I like to wear, like, on an everyday basis. This is the type of style I like. What is up here? I have no idea. I have the Urban Decay Full Spectrum Palette. And I bought that. I haven't even opened this at all. I bought that when it went on sale. I was kind of upset last time I bought their last, you know, palette, and it went on sale and I could have just waited and bought it. And this is what it looks like. Oop. And I know some people were kind of torn about it, but I swatched it and I liked it, so I bought it. And I have most of their palettes, like most of the big palettes I have. I have my first Viseart palette. I am so excited about this palette. I've been wanting one, and I saved up my Shopkick points, and I bought one. And this is how it looks. This is the dark mattes. I am so excited about this palette. So excited. I heard great things about Viseart. Only thing is that price point. Whew. I have a couple more things, I promise. And I bought from Storybooks Cosmetics. I got their Harry Potter wand collection. And I do have a video on these babies. They're so pretty and they're heavy. But I have the brushes. And they are coming with another brush set soon. Can't wait. And I got these for free. I got the with the points for Sephora. I got the Glam Glow set, the mini set, and the Josie Maran. I got their set as well. And that's everything I've purchased for the holidays. Sorry for the bad hair. And sorry for my makeup looking all crazy. That's what happens when I don't apply any kind of eyeshadow on my crease. When I use any kind of liquid eyeliner, liquid liner, it goes right up there because my lids are so hooded and greasy. Oily is a better word. But I hope you enjoyed my video. If there's anything that you see here that you would like a swatch on, please leave me a comment down below. If you want me to go into more detail about any particular product, please leave me a comment. And until my next video, have a great day or a great evening. I hope that you have great positive days, and I'm sending positivity your way. Bye.